Again, we need to re-log in the session. It will become like that. Do it fast. Shall we start? Shall we start the session? Yes, welcome to the session. So first session we have discussed about what is series and shunt feedback amplifier, inverting and non-inverting amplifier. So next we'll move on to the applications. As you know that operational amplifier can be used to amplify AC as well as DC signals. So it's not only used for amplification, as I told you, it is used for some operations. So that is the morning you have studied the comparator Smith trigger. So next we'll be having summing, scaling and averaging amplifiers. So before going to that, can you observe here that there are three images in the slide? Can you observe the sensors? There are many sensors like temperature sensor, humidity sensor, IR sensor and many more sensors. So here, why I've taken sensor here is, so for example, if I tell you to do the temperature monitoring for a day, so what you'll do is you'll monitor the temperature. So always will be meant for, or you want to do any sensing for accurate values. So it should not be a wrong values, or it should not be the incorrect values. For example, if I want to monitor the temperature right now, for example, 25 degrees centigrade, this has to be 25 degrees centigrade. So I'm expecting my sensor to be accurate. If it is not accurate, what will happen? Instead of showing 25 degrees centigrade, it may show 24.7 degree or it may show 25.5 degrees centigrade. So what will happen? Expected is 25. I have designed for 25 degrees centigrade, but it is exceeding the value or it may come below of that. So should not be efficient, because if you want to proceed with an converters, for example, if you want to convert this into some digital values and it will be processed for analog things, means I mean to say digital to analog converter, from analog to digital converter. If you are feeding these data for the processing, in the processing itself, we may go on wrong. So that's why your thing has to be, whatever the things you are doing is, it should be accuracy, should be accurate. So output should be accurate with respect to input. So in regarding sensor, what I've told you, it is the changes in the temperature may happening. Instead of measuring 25, it may be below 25 or above 25. That is not the large changes, it is small changes. Like 24.7 means 0.3 difference, 25.5, 0.5 variation. So this small variation, we can say it is offset. The small change in output voltage is, so even though you're expecting the value of this, but you're getting variation. That is, we can say output offset voltage. Just coming to the second image, instrumentation amplifier. So in your lab, when you are doing, you're going to check with a regulated DC supply. When you are applying, just tuning to 12 volts, once you cross-check with your multimeter, it is not 12 volts. So you may get 11.5 or 11.99, or sometimes your multimeter is correct than your AC regulated supply. Due to the two variation is due to some internal circuitry. So the internal circuit may be any device, or due to some resistance value, or due to some power supply variations. So due to these variations, your output may get disturbed. So how to avoid that small changes in the output value is that, that is, you're going to nullify those offset values. So you're getting into an accurate output value. instead of taking that accuracy, some x plus r minus value, you're eliminating that. You're nullifying the offset. So, and one more here it is, these two are for DC devices. So DC applications are, I can talking about the sensor and transducers are used in DC amplifier. Now coming to the AC amplifier, you can observe in the down image is your audio amplifier. So audio can be received through mic, or it may be USB, or it may be MP3, or any indifferent form. How AC amplifier can be used in audio amplifier is your audio amplifier consists of many stages. So in when you are using for an AC amplifier, biasing is must. In amplifier, what we are studied in your first module is, for amplification purpose, you need to bias. So in biasing, what is the first step? You need to make your transistor in saturation, and you need to find out the biasing values by using DC source. Whenever you are riding AC signal on DC, so you require a coupling capacitors. So you're already aware of it. So in common source and common source with source resistance, you have written in the circuit coupling capacitor towards input and output. So coupling capacitor will be used in AC amplifier. It is not used in DC amplifier. That is a one major difference. So now in this, so what I mean to say is, DC applications will, like your sensor and instrumentation amplifier, and AC amplifier is your audio amplifier. So next, before going to start with the topic, let me see what is DC amplifier exactly. In DC amplifier, what will happen? Your source is input in terms of DC source. So whatever the changes in the output happening only with respect to DC levels, the DC input levels. So here, what I have told you now, just now it is offset, like temperature 25.5 or 24.7. That is, we can say it is offset voltage. How to make that offset voltage to zero? You can have just by adding one extra component in your circuit or in design. The extra component may be your potentiometer, or you can use some external offset null circuitry or external offset voltage compensating network like this. So that can be used to nullify the offset. So that extra circuitry is your potentiometer. The potentiometer can be used to nullify the offset, or you're making your output is accurate output. So what is the expected value? So that is by using a potentiometer. The potentiometer will be designed, and the value of the potentiometer is decided based on the application or based on your requirement. Next, coming to the AC amplifier. In AC amplifier, as we know that input is analog. Analog signal may be a switch, or it may be a sinusoidal waveform. So I told you the application is audio amplifier, audio receiver system. The audio receiver system, what you're going to receive is voice, audio, only audio. Voice, or I can speech. Is these two are in analog in nature. So this is going to be amplified by an AC amplifier. So the main parameters you should know in AC amplifier is like frequency limit. What is the bandwidth? So from a low frequency and high frequency and gain. So what will be the things you should be taken care in AC amplifier? In DC amplifier, we will be completely worried about accuracy. In AC amplifier, bandwidth, that is bandwidth we can define as high frequency minus low frequency, FH minus FL, and also gain bandwidth. Here also DC gain, but sometimes will be very much particular about the accuracy. Next, coming to the AC amplifier, as I told you, AC input is riding on some DC level. So DC is required for the biasing. It is necessary to use an AC amplifier with coupling capacitors, as I told you. The function of coupling capacitor is not only bypasses DC. So coupling capacitors should not disturb the biasing. So it won't affect the offset value. But the one more thing is, the coupling capacitor used for two purposes. The one is to block DC, allow AC. And second thing is, it is going to limit the lower cutoff frequency. It is going to judge what is the low cutoff frequency value in AC amplifier. So example, audio receiver system. Just observe the circuit here. So operational amplifier is a differential input voltages. So it has two differential terminals. Always output is the difference between two input terminals. the two input terminals, say positive and negative terminal, I can say it is V1 and V2. So observe here, both the terminals are grounded. When both the terminals are grounded, or you're not giving any input to this, what will be expected output? The expected output will be obviously zero output. But I'm not getting zero output, so I'll get some offset value. Means like say 2 millivolts, 4 millivolts, like in terms of millivolts. The offset value is given by the manufacturer based on the ICs. Like 741, the different offset value. Similarly for 350 for different values. Different ICs having its own offset value. Here it is. For example, offset, but expected output is zero, but you are not getting zero. The offset value will be your output, 2 millivolts, say 2 millivolts. So VOO means offset, output offset voltage, output offset voltage, VOO. So here it is, this offset can be nullified because I'm not giving any input here. Why should we have 2 millivolts? So the 2 millivolts has to be nullified to zero. How to make that output offset voltage to zero? Just observe here, input offset voltage. The first method is, input offset voltage is nothing but you are just applying a voltage between two input terminals of an op amp. Why you want to apply voltage? To nullify the output, or you are just getting your output to zero. So that is, input offset voltage is defined as the voltage that must be applied between the two input terminals of an op amp to null or bring the output voltage to zero. So that is nothing but, so here 2 millivolts offset means I need to reduce somehow, either in the first terminal or second terminal, the 2 millivolt signal will be applied here. So 2 millivolts, and here it is zero, and here it is, difference between those two will be getting zero. So here it is the prediction of output offset voltage polarity. So either positive offset or negative offset is very difficult. So you need to find out the polarity. Based on the polarity, we need to predict either I can add or I can subtract the offset value. Next, coming to this offset nulling techniques. So why I am telling this techniques? These are the basics. This is not in your syllabus. Before going to analyze the AC and DC amplifier, this offset nulling is required and necessary for only the DC amplifiers. In AC amplifiers, we may use these techniques, or we can use output coupling capacitor. So now, as I told you, this you required one extra component in your circuit to null the offset is potentiometer. So normal potentiometer you required. The potentiometer value will be chosen by the designer based on his requirement or application. So potentiometer value will be 10 kilo ohm and 100 kilo ohms. The frequently used potentiometers are, I can say, POT. So most of the manufacturers and most of the ICs will be getting the information of which are the pins will be dedicated for offset null. So in that, just observe 741 IC. In 741 IC, you can observe just a red arrow mark. This is the pin 1 is dedicated for offset null, and pin 5 is dedicated for offset null. So 1 and 5 is dedicated for offset null. So in some pin configuration, they are specified. In some pin configuration, they are not providing any pin option to specify the offset. So we need to apply external offset nulling compensating network. Some extra things we need to add, if not in the pin. So second technique is external offset compensating network. When we'll go to the second option, so if the some pins doesn't have this offset null functioning, then only we'll go with the external offset compensating network. So now just observe the same circuit, the first circuit, what I told, that both the terminals are grounded. When both the terminals are grounded, expecting 0 volt, but I'm not getting 0 volt, just assume like that. Output offset voltage will be having. So how to nullify to 0 volts? Just by connecting a potentiometer across the pin 1 and 5. So connecting a potentiometer across 1 and 5, as you know that the potentiometer has 3 terminals. So at either end of the terminal is connected to pin 1 and 5. And one more, you can see the wiper is connected to the middle, to the negative supply always. Remember, the wiper has to be connected to negative supply. And potentiometer is connected between pin 1 and 5 because in 741 IC, it is dedicated pin 1 and 5 for offset null. Now, till how long you are going to vary the pot? So the pot will be varied till the offset become 0. The offset has to be 0. The potentiometer will be varied. Next, here it is. I told you it is offset nulling compensation network. So when you are going to use offset nulling compensating network, so when you are not having option in the pins, that time we'll be using offset nulling capability. So next, so op amp with offset voltage compensating network. See here in the pin 1 and 5, I've not connected any potentiometer here. So just we have used this network, compensating network. It consists of three resistors, RA, RB, RC. RA is connected to the supply, positive and negative supply. So here it is connected to inverting terminal. So first let me explain you how exactly this compensating network works. Just observe that compensating network, it consists of RA. It is connected to plus VCC and minus VEE. Just observe the wiper at the middle. If it is middle, the whole resistance is RA. The resistance is divided into two equal parts, RA by 2 and RA by 2. These two resistors in parallel. So maximum resistance I can expect is RA by 4. So RA by 2 parallel with RA by 2. If you do it, you'll get RA by 4. So now, as you know that RA is connected to plus VCC and minus VEE, when you're going to go with plus VCC and when your wiper is moving down to minus VEE, that can be decided based on the polarity of your offset. So just observe here, if VOO, output offset voltage is positive, when the output of offset voltage is positive, as you know that output is difference between two input signals. So whenever V1 is greater than V2, your output is positive. So V1 is greater than V2. V2 is smaller, V1 is larger. So what you have to do is, either you need to get back V2 to the same value of V1. Say V1 is 5 volts, V2 is 2 volts. So what your induction is, by varying this setup, you need to get back V2 also 5 volts, making both the voltages at the same level. So V2 should be increased until it equals to V1. So how can you do that? That can be increased by moving the wiper towards plus VCC. If the polarity is positive of output offset voltage, moving your wiper towards VCC. So if V output offset voltage is negative, so when the output is negative, when V2 is greater, when V1 is greater, it is positive. When V2 is greater, it is negative. So wiper can be moved towards minus VE. We can observe here. Wiper is moved towards minus VE until your offset reduced to 0. So your intention is here, by using both the techniques, you are nullifying the offset value, getting accurate output voltage. So next. Next, we'll move to the exact topic, your AC and DC amplifier. Here it is. First, we'll take up with the DC amplifier. The DC amplifier, here you'll be analyzing using three configurations. Inverting amplifier as a DC, how inverting can be used as a DC, how non-inverting can be used as a DC amplifier, how differential amplifier can be used as a DC amplifier. As I told you, this offset nulling is must and is necessary in DC amplifier. The DC offset nulling can be done by using either using a potentiometer or by using compensating network, that is connecting three resistors, RA, RB, RC. And here the compensating network can be connected. For example, it is inverting amplifier. So inverting amplifier, you are all familiar with the circuit. So it consists of R1 RF components, and you're applying voltage V into the negative terminal. So it is called inverting amplifier by grounding the non-inverting amplifier. As I told you, one more extra component is your potentiometer. Potentiometer can be connected between pin 1 and 5 to null the offset. The wiper is connected to negative supply. As usual, load resistor. As you know that the output voltage can be given for inverting amplifier is minus RF by R1 into Vin. Just observe here. Here, instead of directly grounding the non-inverting terminal, you are connected ROM, offset minimizing resistor. This resistor can also be used. Your intention is you need to make V1 and V2 at the same potential. Just observe at the terminal V1, or I mean to say, resistors at the negative terminal are R1 and RF. Both are in parallel. So due to this resistance, your potential may vary. So similarly here, I need to make the same potential across terminal 3. So that can be done just inserting a resistor. That resistor, I can call it as an offset minimizing resistor. The resistor value will be chosen in such a way that it should be same as your inverting terminal resistor values. So R1 parallel RF. The total resistance is R1 parallel RF. This is one technique. So offset nulling using potentiometer. Just coming back to the second circuit. Here I have not connected any potentiometer. Here, because in pin 307, they are not provided offset nulling pins. They are not dedicated any pins for the offset nulling. So here we'll be using external voltage compensating network. External voltage compensating network consists of three resistors. As I told you in the previous slide, RA wiper will be moved when VOO is positive. Wiper will be moved downward when VOO is negative. So based on that, so RA, RB, RC, this is a compensating network. And remember where you're going to connect this voltage compensating network is, you need to remember when it is an inverting amplifier, means I'm talking about inverting amplifier, this voltage compensating network will be connected to the non-inverting terminal. If it is non-inverting terminal, the compensating network will connect it to inverting terminal. So here, it is an inverting amplifier. As you know that Vin is applied to the negative, the compensating network will be connected to the reverse of it, means non-inverting terminal. So this way, you're going to nullify the offset. Here, whatever may be the resistance will be included or what included, it should not affect on my gain. The gain should remain constant. Only I need to nullify the offset. Here, none of the derivation is there for this. You need to practice the circuits. So inverting the two circuits, one is by using potentiometer and one is using this compensating network. This is about inverting amplifier. So you need to remember here, you need to write an inverting circuit and here you need to include offset minimizing resistor, R1 parallel RF, and your potentiometer connected to pin number 1 and 5. Or if not remember pin number, just connect like this, and the middle one will be connected to the wiper. And here you need to specify what is V0. It is minus RF by R1 Vin. Similarly here, external offset voltage compensating network. That is, RA is connected to positive and negative supply and resistor RB. And RC will be the voltage across V2 terminal. So next, coming to the non-inverting amplifier. As you know that non-inverting amplifier is, you're giving input to the non-inverting terminal. Again, OM will be common in all DC amplifiers and AC amplifiers. ROM, offset minimizing resistor. What is the resistor value? What is the resistors or total resistors connected in terminal 2? R inverting terminal. So R1 parallel RF. So here you're connecting a potentiometer because it is provided here. Next, how to connect the external offset compensating network? The external compensating network, as I told you, if it is a non-inverting amplifier, that will be connected to inverting terminal, towards inverting terminal. So the inverting terminal is, you can observe here. So here R1 RF is already there in your inverting amplifier. Just observe here, the left side of the circuit. R1 RF is already present. Just you need to add to this R1 terminal is by RC and RB. And this, the three resistors are your external offset compensating network. This RA, RB, RC is connected to this input R1 side. And here again, ROM is must. And what is the gain of a non-inverting amplifier? Gain is 1 plus RF by R1 into Vin. So here also 1 plus RF by R1 Vin. Here So what will be the resistance value? This R1 plus RC, this is for the terminal V1, R1 plus RC is equal to R1. So you have to choose a value in such a way that it should be equivalent to R1. Next, coming to the differential amplifier, how differential amplifier used in AC, AC DC amplification purpose. So you know that differential amplifier has two different input voltages. In inverting, either will be give only one input with a positive or negative. In differential amplifier, you will be applying two input signals, Vx and Vy. The circuit is simple. Here it has two resistors, R1, RF. In differential amplifier, again, the second input Vy will be having the resistance R2, R3. And here again, offset nulling by using potentiometer. So here in differential amplifier, the one thing you need to remember is you need to choose the resistor value in such a way that R1 should be equal to R2 and R3 is equal to RF. So what is the gain output voltage of differential amplifier? It is difference between two input signals with the inverting gain. So minus RF by R1 into Vx minus Vy. This is output voltage. Next, coming to the second technique, voltage compensating network. The voltage compensating network, again, it will be confusion that I told you in the inverting amplifier, compensating network will be towards non-inverting terminal. Whereas in non-inverting amplifier, the compensating terminal, compensating network will be towards inverting terminal. Now in difference amplifier, it will be connected to non-inverting terminal, that too towards R3. So just observe the difference in the left circuit and the right circuit. So here R2 as it is, after R3, instead of grounding, you need to connect here your compensating network. It consists of three resistor again, RA, RB, RC. So RA is connected to positive, RB and RA is connected to negative supply also. So and this is a condition you need to remember. R1 is always equal to R2 and R3 plus RC. This everything is equal to your feedback resistor. So next, we'll move on to the how inverting amplifier can be used as an AC amplification purpose. In AC amplification purpose, here it is, as I told you, in AC amplifier, you'll be using coupling capacitor. Input coupling capacitor is you're going to bypass the DC. It allows only AC, one thing. And I told you, it is going to limit your low cutoff frequency. It is going to tell you how much is the lower cutoff frequency this circuit can handle. That is by using this coupling capacitors. So just circuit is so simple. It is just an inverting amplifier from here to here. Here just it is complete inverting amplifier. The extra thing is you have added an input signal with a respective input resistance and input coupling capacitor. So this complete circuit is your inverting. You're just adding these three components. And here it is potentiometer. And ROM must, I told you, for offset minimizing resistor. That value will be based on these resistors. So what is the output? Here again, same in AC also. Your output is minus RF by R1 into Vin. Next, coming to the AC non-inverting amplifier, giving input to the non-inverting terminal. What is the input setup? Vin followed by Rin followed by input coupling capacitor. So this is negative terminal is grounded. And this ROM, as you know that this resistance is ROM and potentiometer. So non-inverting terminal gain is our output voltage is 1 plus RF by R1 into Vin. So here how to find out the limit? As I told you, the coupling capacitor is going to be limit the lower cutoff frequency. How can you limit the lower cutoff frequency? You have to design in such a way that the choosing the capacitor value on the resistance RIF and R0. So here just I'll tell you about audio system. In audio system, you have many stages, like one or two, more than one stages. So what will happen? The DC is must for biasing, as I told you. What will happen in between the stages? This coupling capacitor is connected between the stages. Like first and the second stage, you need to insert a coupling capacitor. What this coupling capacitor will do? It will avoid the DC level amplification. Here we need not to amplify DC signal. I'm worried about completely AC signals. My intention is to amplify only AC signals. So that can be avoided by using coupling capacitors. So just to observe what is CI here. CF is 1 by 2 pi RC. So as you know that Here FL is, I'm particular about low frequency, 1 by 2 pi. C is nothing but only one capacitor you'll find in your circuit, CI. What is the resistance? RIF plus R0. So FL is low frequency cutoff. CI is coupling capacitance between the stages. It is used for DC blocking. Yes. RIF is feedback input resistance. So AC input resistance of the second stage. So RIF is always AC input resistance of second stage. So R0 is AC output resistance of the first stage. So have you observed in the circuit? Rin is equal to R0 here. Rin is R0. I can say output resistance is a source resistance. So AC output resistance of the first stage are source.